there are two teams. Each team member will come up to the stand one at a time and compete with a member from the opposite team to score points.
Not now, Andy.
Andy.
With your other side. To ensure a friendly rivalry and fun for the audience and other team members, the teams will be ladies versus gents, and everyone will be competing against their partner on the other team. To start with, let's have the gents over here and their respective mates over there. The first contestant will be Jamie and Grippy. So to start with, let's have the rules. One team member will pick a clue and a present. I will open the box and I will read the clue aloud. The players will bid on how many notes they think it will take for them to name the tune. The team who did not pick the clue bid first. Bluffing is okay. When someone wants to stop bidding, they will tell the other player to name that tune. The specified number of notes will be played, and the person who bid lowest must name the tune. If they name it correctly, their team gets 3 points. If they cannot, the pianist will play the same notes again, and the other team member will get a chance to name it for 2 points. If neither can name it, then I'll play a recording of the entire song. The first team member who is playing to shout out will get 1 point. The rest of the audience must remain silent during this entire thing. And if you can name it, the person to shout out first gets 1 point. Are there any questions?
Got it.
What's the first song?
I can pick a clue. May I pick a clue?
Yes, you may pick a clue.
That's
me.
And hand it to you. When you know the time.
This song was originally written for Thanksgiving. The author and composer was a minister named James Pierpont, who composed the song in 1857 for children celebrating his Boston Sunday School Thanksgiving. The song was so popular that it was repeated at Christmas and has been reprised ever since. The essence of a traditional Christmas is captured in the lyrics and the sound effects, using the bells that become synonymous as the arrival of Santa to the delight of children of all ages. Grampy, you may start bidding.
I'll bid 100 notes.
The maximum number of notes is 10.
Why did you say that? I bet you 10 notes.
Name that tune, Grampy.
Over the years, the fashion for fig puddings mentioned in the song has faded. But for the curious, The recipe consisted of cakes mixed with butter, sugar, eggs, milk, rum, apple, lemon and orange peel, nuts, cinnamon, cloves, and ginger. Mike, you may start bidding.
3 notes.
2 notes.
Name that two.
The next contestant will be Rich and Tracy. This famous Christmas song starred life as a poem created by an American advertising executive called Robert May. He was asked to produce a poem that could be given away to children by a Santa Claus employed by a department store at Christmas. In 1949, singer Gene Autry recorded a musical version of this poem composed by Johnny Marks. In 1964, it was made into a Christmas television special. It is still shown today during the holiday season. You pick, so you start.
6.
5.
4.
Okay, go ahead.
Walking in a winter wonderland.
No.
The other person had a chance to name it for 2 notes. The same number. 2 points at the same number of notes.
Okay.
That is correct. According to Torm, the song was written during a blistering hot summer. In an effort to stay cool by thinking cool, the most performed Christmas song was born. The strong imagery in the words encompass the essence of the family Christmas. The notion that a traditional Christmas should be white is also expressed in the words of this Christmas song. Mike, you may start bidding.
No.
4.
3.
0.
2. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
3 points!
Oh, what?
Woo! Alright!